Countdown, presented by BSC, Investors Protection Fund.
Well, the Supreme Court has allowed mining in Goa with riders itself. And joining us right now is Rakesh Arora, Managing Director for Macquarie Capital Securities, who tracks the metal and mining space and has a very reputable name in this sector itself. Rakesh, thanks for taking this call. This is something that you've been talking about for the last couple of months now. Your reaction to this Supreme Court announcement that we just picked up a few minutes back?
Yeah, I would say that it's mixed news flow. Mm-hmm. Meaning it was always expected that some relief will come through. But by putting a cap of 20 million ton, which is neither here nor there, industry was doing 50 million ton of production and sales prior to the ban. So 20 million ton is just 40% of what they were doing earlier. And also it will take some more time before mining actually starts. So I would say that it's not really that big a positive news, but yeah, it's a good first step in the right direction.
You know, Rakesh, take us through a little bit of a detailed breakup as far as what the market or what the investors need to keep an eye out for, because clearly, as you mentioned, the stocks also cooled off a little bit from the initial euphoria that we saw. That 20 MTPA cap that we're actually talking about, right now, to what I understand, the contribution is pretty much zero. It's only by FY16 where the analysts are actually expecting something to come in. You still think there's going to be a huge negative with the cap being limited to only 20 MTPA and the upside hence getting somewhat limited?
Yeah, meaning, see, remember that for a company like Cessa Sterlite, which is the most impacted one, prior to the ban, iron ore was 15% of consolidated EBITDA.
Okay.
And now, post the ban, it will be like 3-4%. So, it's reduced in its importance dramatically. So, until unless, this 20 million ton cap is relaxed, or there's a time frame of relaxing this 20 million ton cap, I think it's not really a positive news flow for Cessa Sterlite.
What kind of upside would one actually estimate out here, Rakesh, from your own model in terms of what the estimates look like as far as the potential is concerned, as and when something starts moving out from those mines itself? What kind of correlation would we talk about here?
See, every 1 million ton of sales is around 1.1% on the EPS for Cessa Sterlite. So assuming that the same proportion is maintained, which was there prior to the ban, where they were doing around 14 million ton out of this 50, which is 30% of total state's production. So let's assume that they get that same 30% out of 20 million, which is 6 million ton. We're expecting 5-6% impact on earnings for Cessa Sterlite over a period of 2 years till the time this is fully operational. But it's not simple maths, because they might need to cut a lot of costs to operate at these low level of production.
Rakesh, we were talking about the whole long drawn process, and in fact, I'm looking at a report which you released just a few weeks back as well. That also is another major concern as to far as how this entire process could play out. Explain to us as to what we'd seen with Karnataka, and if a similar situation could happen here in Goa as well, because it clearly took a lot of time for that.
Yeah, fortunately, the Goa government is much more keen to get this started.
Okay.
So we are hoping that it will not take the same long time that it took in Karnataka. And also Karnataka had a little bit of political uncertainty during that time. So that could have delayed the decision making. So I would tend to think that things will move much faster in Goa. And probably we should start seeing something by end of FY15 itself.
In terms of your call on the counter, I believe you have a target price of 224. Does that still hold?
Yeah, that holds, but that's not driven by iron ore. As I said, its contribution has become too low. So it's more driven by, the other things.
And your top picks, Rakesh, right now in the metal pack, looking at the way it's been panning out over the last couple of weeks?
Yeah, so Jindal Steel and Power is what we are pushing as our top pick. And among the base metals, I think Cessa Sterlite still merits an attention.
Countdown, presented by BSC, Investors Protection Fund.